Welcome to an example on consumer surplus. We're given x is the number of items, the demand function is d of x, and the supply function is s of x. We want to determine the equilibrium point and then find the consumer surplus at the equilibrium point. Let's begin by reviewing consumer surplus. When a consumer receives x items of a product, a certain amount of pleasure or utility u is derived. The consumer surplus is a utility received for which there is no payment. An example might be if you decide to spend $300 for a tablet computer, and then you go to the store and it's on sale for $250, then you're receiving $50 of utility or pleasure because you're not having to spend that extra $50. If we look at the demand function on the coordinate plane, and let's say the point QP is the point of equilibrium, then this area here represents the consumer surplus. Notice how there are consumers over here that are willing to pay a higher price and therefore are receiving utility when the price is down here at P. To determine the consumer surplus, we'll find the integral of the demand function from 0 to Q and then subtract Q times P. So we're finding the area under the demand function from 0 to Q and then subtracting out the area of this rectangle, which is Q times P, leaving us with this area here, which is the consumer surplus. So going back to our example, the equilibrium point is the point where the supply and demand are equal to each other. So we want to begin by determining when d of x is equal to s of x. Well, d of x is equal to 500 minus 0.2x, and s of x is equal to 0.6x. Let's go ahead and add 0.2x to both sides. That would give us 500 equals 0.8x. And now we'll divide both sides by 0.8 to solve for x. 500 divided by 0.8 is equal to 625. Now that we found the quantity of the equilibrium point, we just have to find the price P. And we can use either the demand function or the supply function to find P. Let's go ahead and use the supply function because it's a simpler function. S of 625 would be equal to 0.6 times 625, which is equal to 375. So the equilibrium point would be the point when the quantity Q is 625 and the price P is $375. So with the consumer surplus formula, capital Q is 625 and capital P is 375. Before we find the consumer surplus though, let's look at the graph of d of x and s of x on the coordinate plane. Here's the demand function and here's the supply function. We just found the equilibrium point, this point here, where the quantity is 625 and the price is $375. So to find the consumer surplus, we're going to find the area of this region here. So the consumer surplus is going to be equal to the integral of the demand function, which is 500 minus 0.2x from 0 to 625 minus Q times P, which is 625 times 375. So we'll first find the antiderivative of 500 minus 0.2x. That would be 500x minus 0.2 times, this is x to the first, so we'd have x to the second divided by 2. We evaluate this at 625 and then 0 and then find the difference and then subtract this product here, which is 234,375. And notice how here 0.2 times 1/2 or divided by 2 would be 0.1. So when we substitute 625, we'll have 500 times 625 minus 0.1 times 625 squared minus, notice when x is 0, these are both 0, then we have minus 234,375. And this simplifies to $273,437.5 minus $234,375. And this difference comes out to $39,062.5, which means the consumer surplus is $39,062.50. Which also would be the area of this region here and represents the utility or pleasure received by the consumers purchasing this product. I hope you found this helpful.